I'd like to welcome everyone to the Upshur County Commission meeting for March 28, 2019. With a moment of silent meditation and prayer, followed by the pledge of allegiance, and then we'll have the approval of the minutes for March 21st, 2019.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Welcome, everyone. We'll have an opportunity to look at the minutes.
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Is there any additions or corrections? I'll entertain a motion to approve.
I'll make a motion to approve.
Second.
We have a motion and a second. All those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed, same sign. Motion carries. 9:05, we have an appointment with Lori Aldridge Harvey, Upshur County Family Resource Network Director and Team Leader for Upshur County Partners in Prevention, requesting for the month of April 2019 to be proclaimed as Child Abuse Prevention Awareness Month and presentation of Children's Memorial Flag Proclamation.
Is there going to need to be rescheduled for another date due to personal illness?
Okay. So we have an appointment at 9:30 with Addie Hellman on behalf of Women's Aid in Crisis, presentation of Sexual Assault Awareness Month Proclamation. 9:45, Earl Smith with the Upshur County Solid Waste Authority, presentation of proclamation for approval and signature declaring April 2019 as Make It Shine Month. 1:30, we have appointment with Record Services meeting, discuss procedures to dispatch Record Services. Some of the items for discussion action are approval. One is approval and signature of the Upshur County 2019-2020 fiscal year budget.
I move we approve.
A second.
We have a motion and a second. All those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed, same sign. Motion carries. Two, consideration of fiscal year 20 health insurance changes.
You'll see there's a document on page 9 and 10 of your agenda packet that was provided by EFSO recommending different changes that could be made to the policy. You'll see if you look under the medical / HRA plan changes, they list deductibles, co-insurance, and maximum out-of-pockets limits. And you'll see a national average there, and then also your current rates. And they give you option 1, 2, and 3. If you're interested in only changing one of those, for example, possibly a deductible or maximum out-of-pocket, you can look on the second page, and that will show you the expected savings range for changing one of those items rather than all three. And again, they're on page 9 and 10. And of course, it's an estimated savings. They give you a low end and high end because you are self-insured, and your claims from year to year are unknown.
Carrie, when does a decision need to be made and submitted on this?
They recommended that you make a decision within 30 days of your last meeting with them. So really, you could make a decision next week, and that would still be within the 30 days if you'd like to do that.
I move that we table this and make our decision next week.
Next week?
Mm-hmm. Okay. Give us time now.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I'd also like time to review, so I second that as well.
Okay, we have a motion and a second at the table. All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Opposed, same sign. Motion carries. Three correspondents from Principal Amanda Craig and Christine Campbell. Rock Cave PTO president requesting the donation of pool passes for their annual bingo fundraiser to be held May 4th. Probably the standard 10 passes is. Are you all okay with that?
Absolutely.
I'll make a motion to approve.
A second.
Okay, motion and second. All those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed, same sign. Motion carries. Four, approval and signature of welcome letter for the annual Strawberry Festival souvenir program book in local newspapers.
I move to approve.
A second.
Okay, we have a motion and a second. All those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed, same sign. Motion carries. Five, approval and signature of the fiscal year 19 Port Security Grant Application Resolution and Assurances requesting the amount of $53,751 to purchase one additional camera, six mobile radios, six tasers, and shatterproof film for the courthouse annex foyer and courthouse foyer doors.
So with the addition of the two court security personnel, you have a total of seven bailiffs and court security personnel. However, the grant requires that you have a pre-application meeting with all departments involved with court security, and during that meeting it was agreed that you'd be applying for six of these items because at that time you had thought you were going to be able to fund court security entirely. So we still want to apply for the grant to be able to have some assistance in purchasing these items. So we worked it out where if you have the six, then just two people that are working court security can share a radio and a taser, which is not a problem. The one additional camera would be for the elevator. And the shatterproof film is not bulletproof, of course, but it makes it much more difficult if you were to have an intruder once they shoot the doors. It takes a long time for them to be able to kick them in rather than them just shattering and immediately gaining access to the facilities.
I'll entertain a motion to approve unless you have other questions.
I'll make a motion to approve.
Second.
We have a motion and a second. All those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed, same sign. Motion carries. Six, approval and signature of the Fiscal Year 19 Victim of Crime Act, also known as VOCA, Victim Assistant Grant Application, Standard Condition Assurances for Victim Advocate Services.
This is your grant we've had for several years in the prosecutor's office, haven't we?
Yes.
I move to approve.
Second.
We have a motion and a second. All those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed, same sign. Motion carries. Seven, approval and signature of the fiscal year 20 West Virginia Community Correction Grant Program application requesting the amount of $412,695 to be used to provide alternate suspension and reentry services for eligible offenders. This is just what they're applying for, correct?
That's correct.
Okay.
And they apply for this every year. So I move to approve.
Second.
We have a motion and a second. All those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed, same sign. Motion carries. Eight, approval and signature of an agreement between the Upshur County Commission, or County Commission of Upshur County, and the Board of Education of the County of Upshur, and the Board of Education of the County of Lewis and Microlog, and for the COPS School Violence Prevention Program project. This agreement outlines the agreement by which the contractor will provide services, hardware, software, and installation.
So I request that you table this item until we have time to finalize the contract.
Okay. So we need a motion to table? I move to table.
A second.
We have a motion and a second. All those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed, same sign. Motion passes. Nine, review and signature of a renewal agreement between the Upshur County Commission and Stanton Long Service for groundskeeping services for the 2019 season. Per the renewal clause, owner and contractor agree all For your information, certain items may require discussion, action, and/or approval by the commission. One, release of liability executed by JAA Calvin F. M. Van Aaron, Managing Director for Centerline and Address Data for the unincorporated areas of Upshur County, received from the Upshur County Addressing and Mapping Office as of March 21st, 2019. Two, we have the Upshur County mileage reports for February 2019. Three is public notices. Four, appointments needed or upcoming. Any interest on that, or we haven't heard from them for the unexpired term for Atherton Public Service?
Still waiting.
Okay, our next meeting of the Upshur County Commission will be April 4th, 2019 at 9 a.m. at the Upshur County Courthouse Annex. There will be a special meeting held at 9 a.m. on Tuesday, April 16th, 2019 at the Upshur County Administrative Annex. And that will be to lay the levy. We have a couple of minutes until our 9:30 appointment, so we'll take care of some paperwork. Upshur County Solid Waste Authority. Presentation of proclamation for approval and signature declaring April 2019 as Make a Shine Month. You know, Earl?
Good morning.
That's a quick year.
It's good to be here. We thank each of you commissioners for allowing us to come once again in 2019. I was thinking back about how many times I've been here. Looking without the faces that were here the first time, don't see you. So that makes me an older man in the room. I have with me today our board member, Dr. G. Paul Rector, and also I've given out to you a brochure that each of you will be receiving in your mail either Friday or Saturday or the first of next week. This is a mailing that the Solid Waste Authority sends out. Has for the last 5 years relative to waste control in Upshur County. So one of the things I'd just like to, before we deal with the proclamation, is just give you a little bit of information on some of the things that our Solid Waste Authority does. And if you open up the brochure, you'll see a picture of about six people in there. It shows the director and five board members. And the five board members, and two of these are appointed by the Upshur County Commission. That would be Jay Holland and Joyce Harris Thacker. The others are appointed by the West Virginia Public Service Commission, the Soil Conservation District, and the West Virginia DEP. So the Solid Waste Authority has been in existence since about 1993, and we have dealt with waste control issues in Upshur County for a lot of years. And we've had April Make It Shine proclamations signed an awful lot. I was looking at the proclamation. Probably has the same wording that had several years ago. The only difference would be the date and the people who signed. And that's good. That's good because of many things that are happening that are good. Each year we want to do some house cleaning, spring cleaning, and that's what we're doing. But as you look, open up the bulletin, I do want to note that West Virginia Code requires residents and business to have an approved means of disposal of solid waste and be able to provide proof. And that's accomplished by subscribing and being current on the fees to a solid waste collection service, or maintaining proof that disposing of waste takes place at an approved site at least once each month. So this, everybody has a responsibility for the waste control that they generate, both residents and businesses. And it is important, I think, to note that in this map of Upshur County shows that we have two residential waste haulers in Upshur County. The city of Buchanan covers the territory that's shown there, and Mountain State Waste, whose office is in Weston, covers the other territory in Upshur County. There is another hauler that does commercial work here in Upshur County. That would be Republic Services. And the county is covered in the sense that people have a means of disposing waste. The city of Buchanan maintains a transfer station that anyone can bring their materials there on certain hours. But it's also important to note that it's illegal to burn solid waste, bury solid waste, dump in a roadside dump, and create an open dump on your property. We just want, well, who can enforce this? Any law officer or DNR officer can enforce this. So it's important that we maintain that relationship with the officers, that they would help out in the matter of waste control and littering, that type of thing. And a couple other pictures there. It shows a 2018 paper shred event. That was last September. It was a free event. It was held at Walmart Crossroads Recycling Center next to Walmart. And that will happen again this September. And each year, all fourth graders are given a tour of the City of Buckhannon's Recycling Center at the expense of Dexter County Solid Waste Authority. We've done that for a number of years. We pay the transportation costs, and we provide a snack and give a tour of that. So pretty much any student that's graduated from Buckhannon Upshur High School in the past 12 to 15 years has had a tour of the recycling center and had some education relative to that type of thing. If you look on the back, some of the things for the Upshur County Make It Shine cleanup of April 2019. We do encourage the Adopt the Highway pickups that are planned for April. The celebration of recycling means that the City of Buckhannon and the Solid Waste Authority, I'll be the one representing the Solid Waste Authority, will be at Crossroads Recycling Center, Walmart, on Friday and Saturday, April the, let's see, get the dates. 12 and 13, thank you. I was just looking at the date, and 12 and 13, and so that's Friday and Saturday, so we encourage you to stop by and do that. One of the reasons we do that is people love to recycle, but if they don't do it properly, it creates some real problems. You can imagine when we have corrugated cardboard and people put the packing, styrofoam packing in the boxes in with corrugated cardboard, that's a great major problem, okay? And there are some people that, God bless them, they will put their garbage in that that container out there. That's why in the world that would happen, I don't know, but it does happen. So we'll try and educate people those two particular 2 days. And so we, one of the unique things of, one other thing I do want to mention is that there will be 3 days for disposal of cleanup materials for those who subscribe to the services of either the City of Buckhannon or Mountain State Waste. The first Saturday of April, city customers, and then the second Saturday will be county customers, can take the material up to 2 pickup loads out to the City of Buckhannon transfer station and can be disposed of free of charge. And then the 27th, both city and county can take it. They're taking off Easter weekend, so they're not trying to move that on that weekend. But Mountain State Waste will be doing the same thing at Banks District Fire Department on April the 13th from 8 to 12. So this is quite a service that they're providing, and they're doing it at their cost. And so we appreciate that. So have an opportunity for that. And one of the things that is important that Upshur County has, that not many counties have, is we have free recycling of electronics continuously. Many counties just have just a one-time event here and there, but the City of Buckhannon at the transfer station, you can take any of your electronics out there, go across the scales, tell them what you have, and they will take it free of charge, and it is recycled. And so that's a tremendous service to Upshur County. And we're one of the few counties in the state that have that opportunity. So we appreciate the City of Buckhannon carrying through with that program. There will be a free tire collection event on the first Saturday in June, so people can get rid of a number of tires at that point in time that you've collected. And so we don't want those disposed of out alongside a highway somewhere or over a hill or whatever. So a number of things are happening here in April and this spring relative to keeping Upshur County clean and neat, and we do have a place to be proud of. I know that you all feel that way. So that brings me to the proclamation, and I can read it if you want me to. If you like, I can read the whole proclamation. I'll do that. Okay. It says, County of Upshur, Proclamation, April 2019, Make It Shine Month. Whereas the Upshur County Commission is aware that West Virginians are taking action to work toward the common goal of a clean, safe environment for this and future generations. And whereas one of our most critical objectives must be reduce the volume of solid waste being generated by our citizens and being disposed of in landfills. And whereas our legacy as a county, as a state, as a people rests on our ability to clean up the environment, set the standards for ourselves and future generations. And therefore, we, the Upshur County Commission, do hereby proclaim the month of April 2019 as Make It Shine Month. The Upshur County Commission urges all citizens to participate in programs that would accomplish these objectives. The Upshur County Commission, we encourage participation, the Adopt a Highway and Adopt a Spot programs, given in our hands as 28th day of March 2019. We appreciate that, and if we can get a picture of you signing that and the local media, they promote that, we appreciate it. Any questions? Just keep my
when they shredded, did you have a lot of people participate in that?
The shredded event, I go from my 71-year-old memory, I think it was 68 that we had participated in that, 68 individuals, and somewhere in the neighborhood of 6,500 pounds of paper was shredded.
3 hours of shredding.
Three hours of continuous shredding, and we've done that several years in a row, and it will be done again this September. First Saturday in September after Labor Day. So this is billed as a residential free paper shredding. Commercial businesses, they need to pay for their own.
Burrow, when I had my dump trucks back in the 70s, the coal slowed down for a while, they were almost backed up. We actually went up to the Pentagon. And all of recyclable paper away from the Pentagon to the recycle center. Even when you were loaded, it felt like you were empty. But you just pulled up, and you can't imagine the line of trucks that are sitting at the Pentagon every day to haul the shredded paper on. And you just pull under a chute, fills your truck up, you take off, and then just truck after truck.
Things have changed a lot. One of the things about recycling, everything is always market driven. And the prices of the commodities, whether it be shredded paper, newspaper, magazines, or corrugated cardboard, plastics, the prices go up and down. The demand goes up and down. And so overall, when it first got started in the 70s and in the late 80s and early 90s, the price was up so that private individuals wouldn't want to get into it. The price has dropped to the point now it's difficult for individuals to make a go of recycling and make a living at that.
Back then, nobody was using the internet. There weren't computers. There weren't email and texting.
I bet you didn't even have a phone that you could look at on your
wrist. We had a CB radio.
And telephones were dialed. And I know that your business over the years has been a recycler, and many times you see the truck come out there, and particularly the cardboard. Yeah. Done a good job.
Thank you.
Yeah, we started recycling the cardboard years ago, and it was amazing. The garbage bill dropped like $200 a month by taking the cardboard out of it.
And the good thing, the thing about many small businesses, they will take the recyclers, the recycled material to the recycling center themselves, and there is no cost for that whatsoever. If the city has to pick it up, actually there's going to be a cost,
right,
relative to that.
Yeah, we opt out of the cardboard dumpster and just take it in ourselves.
Right.
Yeah.
Good. We appreciate that.
I'm sure you had this question asked before. How come we don't recycle glass?
I mentioned a minute ago that everything was market driven.
Right.
In 2005, the city of Buchanan stopped recycling glass, and the problem was you could not get enough money out of it after you processed it, collected it, and processed it. You could not get enough money out of it to pay the haul bill of where you took it to. And not only that, but I mentioned contamination. You can imagine when people recycle glass, they throw everything in one common container and take it out there and sort it out, and a lot of glass would get in other materials. Our workers were very pleased when we stopped recycling glass because of that, because of the danger from a broken glass.
Is there a limit on the tire event? Is there a limit to number of tires?
I think that it may have phrases in there. We'll be posting that, but I think they say 10.
Okay.
But generally speaking, the desire is to get rid of tires and not have them disposed over the side of the hill someplace. So they've been pretty lenient about that. I wouldn't suggest anybody bring a tractor trailer over the hill.
Well, I have a friend who just asked that question. They just purchased property, and there's probably 30 tires or more on it. And they asked me, what's the limit? I said, I have no idea.
Generally speaking, they work with you on something like that. But it's one of those things, I throw in the disclaimer. don't sound like Carl Smith told you to do that.
Earl, you want to come up and get a picture?
Okay, yes, Paul, if you can come with me. Thank you.
Okay,
want me to jump over
there?
Terry, I'll entertain a motion to approve the proclamation.
So I move.
Is there a second? Motion and a second. All in